This is TWiT.
Let's talk about the 30,000-foot view. So if I'm reaching for a Sanoid, what problem am I solving?
The problem that you're solving is, you know, like Aaron was saying, ZFS does amazing things to keep your data safe. And one of the biggest things that it does is it's kind of unfortunate that Apple got the branding on the phrase time machine for backups, because that's really what ZFS offers you with snapshots. But the problem is, you know, being able to take an instant atomic snapshot of your entire file system, the entire condition of it at a given moment in time, and access that at any time, roll back to it, do whatever you need to do, that's only as good as you having taken the snapshot when you're supposed to in the first place. So one of your problems is you want to make sure that you're taking these snapshots regularly before something horrible goes wrong that you need to roll back to. And also, as you accidentally kind of alluded to earlier, you need something that will actually delete those for you once they're stale and you no longer need them according to your policy, which that's one of the places where your current system is falling down. You're having to go in and manually delete these monthly snapshots, or else you run out of hard drive space, which can be really inconvenient if you forget to do it. And all of a sudden you're like, hey, you know, why is my application throwing errors because it can't write to the disk? Sanoid can save you from that. You can just have a very, very short, very human readable config file that says, you know, I want to take my usual policy is 30 hourlies, 30 dailies, and 3 monthlies, and it will take them for you on time. It will expire them for you on time, and you know you're covered.
Yeah, and one of the things that's great about these snapshots, if you're not familiar with ZFS, and maybe you can point this out a little bit better, is that the snapshots are incredibly efficient in terms of block space. So as files change, the new blocks will be put into new snapshots, but the blocks that remained the same are actually shared amongst the snapshots. Am I accurate there?
Yes, you're accurate there. Snapshots really blow your mind when you're not used to them. You would think that, you know, my hard drive is just instantly going to be full of old crap, and it really doesn't work that way. Like you said, only the changed blocks, you know, get added to it. It's almost like a Venn diagram. You know, you start out with this one circle and you move it a little bit from A to B. And when you haven't gotten rid of that first snapshot you took, you know, the one circle in the Venn diagram, all that you're really adding is these new blocks on the new snapshot. The only thing from the old snapshot that's taking up space is any of these little blocks on this trailing edge that you might have deleted by the time you got to the new system. It's nowhere near as much data as you might think. What a snapshot really is it's a linked list of block pointers. The snapshot says these are where all the blocks are on the drive that refer to this particular snapshot's data. And as long as any block on the drive is owned by one or more snapshots, and really the current file system is kind of just a special snapshot when it comes right down to it. Basically, as long as any block is owned by the current file system or a snapshot, it's immutable and can't be deleted. Once the last snapshot has unlinked that pointer, that has unlinked that block, now that block can be removed to make room for new things.